Hello Capricorn, and welcome to October reading. Before we start, guys, if messages come through for you, maybe not everything, but there will be tidbits, make sure that you also check your ascendant and you check your moon sign. In the description you will find a link if you don't know how to do it, so that way you can get more messages glued together, right? And of course, if you want a reading, just contact me at cattarot.ca, or my email is in the description and we can discuss which reading is the best for you. So let's start, my dear Capricorn, and let's see what's going to happen. The October, it's going to be a tricky month. Ooh, but you will be on top of the world. The world is coming down as the energy that is pushing through, and this is like really wonderful card to get. It's kind of a half my karma card, which really talks about now. So it's going to be really about being present the entire month. So how do we start this month? We start with October 1st, full moon in Aries, and then we have a second full moon in the same month on the 31st on Halloween, which is going to be full moon in Taurus. This initial start of the month with full moon in Aries is kind of giving us burst of energy, a vigor, and we are feeling better. You're getting Nine of Pentacles, you're feeling comfortable, and this is really matching with your element. So it's almost like if you guys are single, you'll feel really good about being single. You'll feel, look, you know, I don't have to negotiate. It's kind of like independent streak, but you're also having Knight of Pentacles. You kind of like are ready now, almost like to go in a new direction of some sort. Nine of Pentacles means the ultimate friend, and check the goat over here. So there is like this Capricorn peeking right through, right? It's kind of like you're saying that energy that has to come through has to be that slow and steady energy. Nine of Pentacles to me is a really good energy, which means you're kind of like paying attention in kind of like how you're positioning building blocks, whether this is work or relationship, because this is a huge card that now is going to be revealed in kind of like more details, what's going to happen about it. So then you have Knave of Swords. That's a little bit kind of like pesky attitude. Maybe you have a kid who is maybe just too high energy and you're just like tired. You know, you're just kind of like, oh my gosh, I cannot stand this chatter. It's just too many questions. This is kind of like really exhausting energy. Somebody has lots of questions. Maybe you're a supervisor and have a new employee, and like now you're just completely forgotten. Like, I mean, when you were learning something, that like there are lots of questions and lots of kind of like pieces of the puzzle. And but somebody is like, yeah, why this, like, just like it feels a little bit intrusive, right? Like, I mean, Page of Pentacles like talks like that, right? It also could mean some kind of like fast communication, or not necessarily the most polished conversation, right? And in the past we have like Six of Cups, and it's the reverse. Maybe you had thoughts about someone, maybe there's like somebody who is lingering in your life, not necessarily being present in your life, but can be present in your thoughts, and it is reversed, right? So Six of Pentacles to me connects with Mercury retrograde, but Mercury retrograde this month starts on October 13th and it goes all the way to November 3rd, right? And I used to do these annual predictions, and I kind of like did them 3 or 4 years in a row during Mercury retrograde. It was like nothing but hell. So they just like exhausted me. So this first year that I'm deciding not to do it, because for me that Mercury retrograde lasts a little bit longer, so it's going to last almost like up to the 1st of December. So again, will be the same story, but this time around everybody has to really beware of this energy, because part of that Mercury retrograde will be going through the sign of Scorpio. So Scorpio will turn on October 22nd, one day early this time around, and so it's going to be kind of like really sexy time. Lots of temptations about the past partners, which I see here. Maybe something is going to get revoked, but maybe something is going to be recalled. It's kind of going to be really interesting that it kind of can be like, I mean, weird game where you want to be with someone, but that someone doesn't contact you, somebody else contacts you. It's just kind of like going to create lots of confusion. But when we turn into Scorpio, things become obsessive, and that can be seen over here as well. Be very careful. You might have somebody who is obsessive about you, or you may become obsessive about somebody. Literally, this obsession that when Scorpio merges with Mercury retrograde is palpable. It feels like stalking. It feels like, oh my gosh, you know, like, I mean, that somebody is like going to have like steam coming out of their ears, right? So it can also be paranoid. So it's very important to have to set really firm boundaries and also to have self-care in the situation. And this is pretty much what I was talking about. You don't necessarily need to talk a lot. I mean, maybe somebody been talking blah, 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 but you will really understand the energy, and by understanding the energy, you will just maybe be observer in the situation. And you see, it's this kind of like bad and good kind of like sides. And it's only good can pass, bad cannot pass. And the kitty is extremely, extremely wise. This is talking about a new moon over here, and we are talking about that's going to be happening around October 16th. New moon is in Libra, so this is going to be about partnership. And so, a word of caution, I'm telling you, even though I told you it can be really obsessive Scorpionic energy that we will all be affected to, and also is going to be affecting elections in the US, hello, that's going to be very, very tricky. But at the same time, what's going to be happening is that some woodwork relationships that they're pulling back, coming out, will actually create lasting connections, right? So let's see what you have ahead. You have Five of Swords. Be very careful not to kind of like dwell too much in this ego, right? Because ego makes us want to win. Ego wants us to be better. Like, this is a lesson of this card, right? Like, I mean, you can see two losers and one winner, but you're really not a winner if everybody else doesn't win. Sure, this is not practical in life. It doesn't happen all the time like that. But this could be connecting to like somebody who is very vocal, somebody who could be like very abrasive, and somebody who wants things at any cost without really applying diplomacy or tact or timing, right? And hence it can come across really, really weird, right? So you might want to reassess if maybe you also reacted in a knee-jerk reaction, because this card really talks about that. It talks about needing to reassess something that you just kind of like cut out for some reason, right? Oof, you have another five. Why you have like these two fives? And this is kind of like you feeling that you have lost. You feeling that maybe the deal fell through. It's Five of Pentacles, it's not Five of Cups, so this is maybe better on an emotional planet, but it could mean some financial losses. It could mean that some investments are now losing, or it could mean that something is off. To me, ultimately, this card means that maybe there's like somebody in the situation who's not really clear on the direction they want to take. Somebody could be still married. I mean, also the High Priestess talks about secrets. She's like just looking at you, and you know there's like something very secretive, and you don't know what's the freaking password, and you're feeling embarrassed, you don't know what to do, and you eventually move on, not realizing the test was just simply kind of like going deep inside of yourself, try to figure things out. So this card here could mean that somebody's also married in a situation, and as such they're not able or willing to kind of like leave that situation, and hence things are really, really complicated. So I'm not going to manage to get under 10 minutes as YouTube requests, but anyhow, so this is your environment, and you're getting Nine of Swords. People will be pissing you off this month. I'm not going to lie to you. Like, I can see it here. Words and how people deal with things will, I think what's going to what's going to kind of like really affect you is the speed. You will need to be, you will have to have eye on the ball all the time, very fast. So you will probably want to do high quality, which is like kind of like what I see over here, kind of like do the final touches, but it's going to be never mind, good enough, and you're not feeling comfort about the quality of everything that is really coming through, right? So this is like that wash machine brain, something coming through, and something maybe loading their problems on you, and almost like demanding that you kind of like deal with this. And you thought to yourself, oh my gosh, did I not deal with this? Is this kind of deja vu? What the heck is going on? And maybe this is like kind of what represents these circles here as well. I mean, you can see two circles, but you can also see the infinity sign that is kind of residing here. So let's see your hopes and fears. You have the sun. In this particular category or house, I read the card up and down. So to me, the sun is always the same. It's maybe even a little bit better when it's down, because it's not a scorching sun. Like, right, it's not everything that is exposed. Sometimes like kind of like a little mystery is nice, but you know, like, I mean, you kind of like need clarity of some sort, because your fear is that you're not going to get it, and your hope is that you're going to get it. But just be careful that sometimes too much of clarity too soon kind of like shuts the interest down. It just like it feels, you know, like, I mean, I force this out, and this person is in it, and somebody pulls away. But nonetheless, the Sun card, and you have like now three major arcanas in there, and they're really actually really lovely. So that will be resonating to number one. This will be resonating to number two and three. So you can see, but you're going 3-1, not 1-3. So there is like something that is coming back. It's pulling you into some kind of like past decisions or people from the past. As I said, lots of exes can be coming through. Doesn't have to be necessarily an ex. I always say it's the energy of the ex that can also come through. It is like 7:55 in Toronto in the evening, and it's dark, and somebody is like banging outside on their house. It's unbelievable. And we have Three of Swords. Be very careful. Somebody might get hurt in the end. But this is like maybe the hesitancy. Maybe somebody wants to get through to you, and you're saying, you know, I spent X amount of time, a month, just crying or just dealing with this, not understanding. Like maybe you left, maybe somebody just like stonewall you, because there is like this silence here that is connected, and you turn a new leaf, not even new leaf, new book, new library, new planet. Now you want me to go and relive this? It's going to be really a debate. I also can see here, guys, in your reading, a third party. And it is some kind of a situation. I mean, yeah, I see it here. And of course, it can indicate all kinds of headaches and all kinds of problems that can come up from somewhere. So be very careful about that, right? So as I said, up to 22nd, it's not going to be as difficult, but just be careful. For you, it's going to be a tricky period between the 5th and the 19th. And that's kind of like where the doors can get closed. That can be like where you feel that somebody's too intense, that somebody moves with a much higher speed that you want to, and you will kind of like reassess things over there. And just take as much time as you need, because if somebody pushes you, you're going to feel bullied, and it's not going to be the shoe that fits. So take your time in what you are doing, but you need to remember that for some, this new renewal of something that has been a past, so it might not be necessarily a partner that you had in the past, could be somebody who very much reminds you of that energy, and who is now bringing this energy to deal with right back on the table. Remember that this time, this can work very well, and it can be to your satisfaction, but not before you experience every fear and every doubt in a book. So it's going to be a tricky month, and guys, buckle up and just go through it. Take your slow pace if you need it. Make sure you kind of like dot all your I's and cross all your T's, because it's going to be important. So that is from me, guys. Just don't forget, also I have dailies on Instagram and Facebook, so join my social media. It's all down in description, and just like check Cat Tarot on all the media. And don't forget the live Saturdays at 11 Eastern Standard Time, 11 a.m. that is. And check your ascendant, check your sun sign, check your moon sign. You will get more messages. Love you, love you, love you, Capricorn. Have a wonderful month. And let me know how it's going. All the best.